Yes, dear students, in this numerical we are going to find the code vectors for the given generator matrix Z. The question, I am reading the question, the generator matrix for a 6,3 linear block code is given below, where 6,3 stands for n, k, n is the length, total length of that linear block code. Before going for the solution of this numerical, I am assuming that you definitely know that what is n comma k block code, what is the meaning of generator matrix, and how code vector is going to be identified. So my first point, again I am reading the question, the generator matrix for a given 6,3 linear block code is given below. Find all the code words for this code. So generator matrix is given n comma k block code, where n is the total length of linear block code and k is the meshes. So there are three meshes bits and n total six length block code. So now I am going to the solution. The general pattern of block code, as I have explained, this is n comma k, where n is equal to 6, k is equal to 3. This means that meshes block size is 3 and total length n is equal to 6. I have explained just some seconds ago. So for obtaining the code word, now first of all, the given G matrix, you have to separate given G matrix according to the general formula Z is equals to IK, identity matrix IP. Correct? G is equals to bracket matrix bracket IP, IKP. So I is the identity matrix. So easily you can separate identity matrix and P. P is the coefficient matrix. So coefficient matrix can also be separated very easily. So now we know that we have discussed meshes block k is equals to 3. So there will be 2 key power 3. That means 8 meshes codes will be there. From 000 to 111, 000, 001, 010, 011, 100, 101, 110, and last 111. So now you have to write the final answer. I'm going to the final point. That means you have to write the 8 block codes, right? 8 codes for the meshes. So now we are going to start. There is a formula C is equals to MP, correct? C is equals to MP is the formula, and C M is M0, M1, M2. We have identified from the question M is the meshes bits. And P is the parity, not P is the generator matrix. Correct? Please correct it. I want to say that P is the coefficient matrix that has been identified from the generator matrix. Right? So we know that C is equals to MP formula. C is C0, C1, C2. Correct? These are the P is the parity bits. As we have discussed n comma k, there will be three parity bits, three meshes bit. So very important, C is equals to MP. Now C is parity bits, M is meshes bits, P is coefficient matrix. All we know very much from our theory. So C, I have written C0, C1, C2 because there will be three parity bits. M is again 3 meshes bits, and coefficient matrix P, coefficient matrix P we got from the given question generator matrix Z is equals to IP formula. So now it's simple. The multiplication is simple, but after multiply you have to add, and the addition is not simple. Remember this point is very important. The addition will be modulo 2 sum, means XOR gate addition. So the multiplication will be simple. This row will multiply with this column, then this column, then this column, and in between plus sign is not the simple plus sign, it is modulo 2 sum. So we got the general equations for our given question, right? And now we can put meshes M0, M1, M2. Very important. We can put M0, M1, M2 according to our codes 000 to 111, right? So we have solved the code for the 000. we are getting C0, C1, C2 again, triple 0. So the message code word is like this. This is message code word. And this message code word M0, M1, M2, C0, C1, C2. We have to write in this. So total code word length is, total code word length is 6. Correct. Now for the second message 001, similar fashion, you can get the C0, C1, C2 output. And finally, make a table. In this table, M0, M1, M2. We know the M0, M1, M2 from 000 to 111. The message is 3-bit. And parity is also 3-bit. And C0, C1, C2 we got from the multiplication. And the formula for C0, C1, C2. Remember this point, very important. The formula for C0, C1, C2 means from where these values C0, C1, C2 we are getting. We got this C0, C1, C2 value from the formula C is equals to MP. C is equals to MP formula. So now moving to the table. So finally this table, you have to write the complete code word. The question was you have to write the complete code word. And this code word is having 6 digits, 6 bits. So 000, 000. First write message bits, then parity bits. First write again message bit, then parity, message bit, parity, and so on. So you are going to get the complete code word for the given question. Now next question, we are taking second question, the parity check matrix. The parity check matrix of the 7,4 linear block code is given like this. We have to find generator matrix, list all the code vectors. What is the minimum distance between the code vectors and how many errors can be detected and corrected. So this question is having the 4 parts. You have to solve this question step by step. So we know that the parity check matrix, we know that parity check matrix is denoted by H. And now we are going to compare this H matrix with our general formula. So first decide the code word length n comma k. Our question is giving that 7,4 code is there. So n is equal to 7, k is equals to 4, and the formula of H parity check matrix is equals to P transpose. P is very important. Often students remember this P as parity matrix, but P is not the parity matrix. P is the coefficient matrix. P transpose I n minus k. The formula, general formula for H parity check matrix is this. So on comparing, we can separate coefficient matrix from the given matrix H in the question, and we can separate I identity matrix. Now on separation, we got the P matrix. P transpose matrix is this. And now if we want to write the P matrix from the P transpose, definitely you have to take the transpose again. The row will become column and column, this one. This row will become column. This row will become column. This row will become column. So size of the matrix is 4,3. Now you have to write generator matrix Z. And the formula for generator matrix Z is equals to IP. Correct? Z is equals to IP. So we know that I identity matrix for 4 order is like this 1 1 1 1 diagonal, and we have written I matrix for 4th order, and P matrix we have just identified from the H matrix. Ye wala matrix H se aaya hai, to H se aapne compare karke is P matrix ko, coefficient matrix ko yahan par aap likhenge according to formula ZIP. First part ka answer aapke paas aa chuka hai. Second part ka answer, we know that C is equals to MP. Second part hame calculate karna tha. Second part mein calculate karna tha aapko code vectors. List all the code vectors. So now the message bit is 4. So there will be 00000 to 1111. 16 code will be theirs. Correct? 16 code will be there. And again, I have to write the formula. 16 code will be there. Again, I have to write the formula. C is equals to MP. This C parity. C is known as the parity bits. So C0, C1, C2, I have written 3 because 7,4 code was there. 7 minus 4 is equals to 3. Parity bits are 3, so I am writing this as 3 bits. Message was 4 bits and parity, this is coefficient matrix P. This is parity, this is message, this is coefficient matrix P. So we got the formula, and on multiplying this, the addition will be XOR. Remember this, the addition will be XOR. So again, this was simple as question number 1. You have to write all the 16 codes. You have to write all the 16 code in the table. Correct? In the table, as we have solved in question number 1. Now in the third part, what is the minimum distance between the code vectors? So in third part, the solution is, we know that the minimum distance is equal to the minimum weight of any non-zero code vector. So minimum distance d minimum is equals to 3. Now in the fourth part, focus to the fourth part, how many errors can be detected and corrected? So we know the formula. The solution is, the number of errors can be detected is given by d minimum must be greater than equal to s plus 1. So d minimum is equals to 3. On putting d minimum is equals to 3, you can get s less than equal to 2, which means 2 errors can be detected. Now next, moving to the number of errors that can be corrected. Iska formula aapke paas hai, d minimum greater than 2t plus 1. Ye dono formula aapko theory mein discuss ki hai. Ye dono formula aapko yaad hone chahiye. D minimum greater than s plus 1 for detection. D minimum greater than 2t plus 1 for correction. So you are getting t less than equal to 1 means at most one error can be corrected. Two errors can be detected. Do error hum detect kar sakte hain, lekin correct hum yahan par ek hi error karenge. To is tarike se aapne dekha ye do questions jo hain, jisme dusre question ka second part wo bilkul same first question ki tarah tha. To ye generator matrix, parity check matrix H, कोफिशिएंट मैट्रिक्स पी और कोड वेक्टर लिखने को आपको इन प्रॉब्लम्स में आपने देखा. एंड सिमिलरली इन द लास्ट पार्ट, कितने नंबर ऑफ एरर्स करेक्ट करेंगे आफ्टर डिटेक्शन. ये दो फॉर्मूलेस थे आपके पास. एंड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, सी जो हमने यूज किया न्यूमेरिकल्स में, वो सी हमने यूज किया है पैरिटी बिट्स के लिए. और एन कॉमा के आपका ब्लॉक कोड्स होते हैं, लीनियर ब्लॉक कोड्स, where n is a length of complete length, means अगर n is equals to 7 है तो 7 bit का आपका code होगा, और k की value अगर 4 है तो 4 bit का message होगा. 7 minus 4, n minus k मतलब 7 minus 4, 3, 3 आपकी parity bits होंगी जिसको हम c से denote कर रहे हैं. तो finally इन दोनों numericals को खत्म करने से पहले important terms, generator matrix g, पैरिटी चेक मैट्रिक्स H, दोनों के अपने अपने फॉर्मूलेज हैं. कोफिशिएंट मैट्रिक्स P, कैपिटल P, और पैरिटी बिट्स इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय C. सो दैट्स ऑल फॉर द टू न्यूमेरिकल्स. थैंक यू.